Yeah, alright everybody, this is Cobb, and this video is just going to be me talking about what motivates me, you know, when it comes to creating videos. I've been taking some time to remember back to how it started these past few days, just to make sure that my memory is in check, and I think I'm about good to go. So a long time ago, a WoW expansion was released called The Burning Crusade, and this for me was the beginning. I started out as the biggest noob the world has ever seen. I had no keybinds, I backpedaled, and I used to have the superstitious belief that jumping around during combat would actually make my opponents more likely to miss their melee attacks. So what was it that gripped me to the game right away? I suppose it was escapism. I think that we all go through phases in our lives where we just want to completely bury ourselves in a kind of virtual world, you know, full of mystery and opportunity. I wanted to be that notorious kind of guy that people on my server would, you know, eventually recognize. I wanted to be that guy that you tried to gank and then get killed off of. Then you kind of realize that it was the same guy that your guild was talking about the other day. Or something like that, I don't know. It sounds stupid as hell when I think of it now, but I was only 14 years old when I first started playing, so I was just a bleb. So anyways, I get completely addicted to WoW, which of course my parents absolutely hated. I tried out every class other than Warlock before eventually testing out a Warlock that I named Kobrak, and it just felt right, so I just went with it. But anyways, I was leveling away in the Azeroth zone Feralas, which I think I was level 37 in, or something at this point. I'm playing the Destruction spec at this time, and I duel a Blood Elf Shadow Priest. So I duel this guy. I can't remember who won the duel, but I can imagine that it probably wasn't me. But after the duel was over, this guy asked me why I'm playing the Destruction spec. Am I a Drake Dog fan? And I was just like, nope. You know, who or what is Drake Dog, you know? I had no idea at this point that the PvP videos were even a thing. So this Shadow Priest guy just can't believe it. He's telling me that Drake Dog is the boss of Destruction Warlocks. He'll fucking kill anybody. And I really need to check out his videos. Now, I remember after watching Drake Dog 7, the hairs on my arms were standing on end, you know? I was absolutely blown away. And that's when something changed for me, I think. I guess you could say a kind of seed being planted. I just felt so inspired by the videos by Drake Dog and all the other old school Destro players like Bone Shock, and Grubstrom and Shodar, that I just wanted to see if I could do it myself. Now it might sound like I wanted to get my hands on some attention or something weird like that at this point. Maybe it was like that when I very first started playing, but now it was just about something else. I guess I wanted to see if I could make videos that gave people chills. I wanted to see if I could give people the same feelings with my videos as I got from watching videos by Boneshock or Drake Dog, because I think we've all had that epic feeling before, you know, where after watching a sick PvP video, you just want to log in and blast some PvP music and try and 1v10 an entire Warzone Gulch. It's the inspiration and the motivation that I really loved, and I just wanted to try and replicate that. So I got my hands on some music by Sonic Syndicate and Breaking Benjamin, because that was like the standard PvP music back in TVC. And I learned my first few keybinds, and that is how we started out. Now, my first few videos were just not good. This was back in the days when YouTube had a 5-star rating system on videos. I don't know if any of you guys remember that. And most of mine were rated around 3 out of 5, so not really that great. But it was so exciting for me. And I remember being literally nervous when reading comments, because a positive or negative comment would just mean so much to me, because I might only get 3 or 4 comments per video. But it was just the most amazing feeling when someone left a positive comment, because I'd feel like I'd had a good impact on someone's life. Maybe I hadn't outright inspired them or anything, but I'd done as much as I could, and it was just a time of learning for me. I eventually stopped using Windows Movie Maker, and I finally got my hands on Sony Vegas 7, and I taught myself how to edit, what music made good PvP music and stuff like that, which was a long process. But it's led up to this point in time now where I can listen to a song for something like 10 seconds or less, and know if it's a good song for a PvP video just straight away. But again, the editing was just something I found, you know, I was really passionate about, and it just became part of the whole creative outlet. So we very gradually started to build up the channel, and it literally took years. We are talking from the start of TBC until the very end of Cataclysm, so that alone is something like a 5-year time span, to get around 2,000 people subscribed up to the channel. And if you're one of those people watching this video, you're just an absolute legend. I guess it's just strange for me to look back now on some things. Like when I first started playing, having people recognize me as they moved around in the game. That was something that I thought would be the most exciting thing ever. But now that it happens, you know, fairly often, it just doesn't matter. But then again, some things never change. When I made my first few videos in the Burning Crusade, like 7 years ago or something, you know, I would take every bit of criticism, even from obvious trolls, really to heart. You guys don't even know how much I take comments to heart, because when I read them, I'm reading them as if you're watching my video from like over my shoulder and commenting from sitting or standing beside me. So I became hypercritical of my own videos, and I still am. The difference in gameplay and editing skills between Cobrak 8 and Cobrak 17 is massive, but I'm absolutely not satisfied with Cobrak 17 even still. It's completely true, in fact, that I can't watch my big movies like Cobrak 17 back again because all I see are the mistakes I made, even like a week after uploading them. So I am super, super self-criticizing, and it does feel like I'm punishing myself a little bit sometimes, but it's always in the name of improving the content. And if I can keep on improving, hopefully I can keep you guys inspired and motivated, which is what the videos are all about for me, because it just go back to those first few videos that I watched, you know, of Drake Dog or Bone Shock or Grubstrom. I remember how they made me feel. And if I can make even one of you guys feel the same when you're watching one of my montages or big releases, you know, then I'm happy and I'm doing my job right. So alright, I'm not sure how long this video is going to end up. Hopefully I haven't rambled on for too long. But yeah, I've seen a few other YouTubers make videos like this one, and I guess I feel like I had a thing or two to say that I might not have talked about with you guys before. So I guess I want to thank you all for listening in. Remember to comment. Let me know what you're thinking. Hit like if you did enjoy the video. If you want to support the channel further, you can become my Patreon. Links to the Patreon page down below in the video description. Again, thanks for sitting in with me, and I will catch all of you guys a little bit later.